Hi students, good morning. See, we start our standard third lesson second, okay? See, what is the lesson second? Number one, okay? In the previous lecture, we start already this lesson and half part will be completed, okay? Half part has completed. Then, remaining half part, today we discuss, okay? Then, in the previous period, we learn about 3-digit numbers, okay? 3-digit numbers, how to write the 3-digit number, how to write in words and figures, then less, bigger number and smaller numbers using symbols, and then after and before numbers. That terms are already we learned. And the next point is ascending and descending order, okay? Ascending and descending order. Ascending and descending order. See, here some numbers are given for you and you write the ascending order and descending order. Okay, then see here, taking one example, I explain you, okay? Then see here, first example. See here, four numbers are given here, okay? See here, 55, 63, 40 and 80. Then we have to write the ascending and descending order also, okay? First we write the ascending order. Ascending order. Then how to write ascending order? See here, first we read these numbers, okay? Then see here, 55, 63, 40, 80. In the ascending order, you write first small number. In these four numbers, you write first smaller number, okay? Then see here, out of these four numbers, which is the smaller number? Yes, 40. 40 is the smaller number. So we write 40 first, okay? You write 40 and give less than sign, because these numbers are the smaller number, okay? Then see, 40 is writing here, okay? Then see, remember these three. 40 is already written here. That's why we forget this number. Then see, three numbers are remaining. 55, 63 and 80. Out of these three numbers, which number is smaller? Out of these three numbers, which number is small? 55. Then write here, 55. Okay, understood? First we take 40, then forget this number 40, then remaining three numbers we write here smaller number, okay? Then 55 is also written, so forget this number. Remaining two numbers here, 63 and 80. In this remaining two numbers, which number is small? Yes, 63 is small number. So we write here 63. Okay, use this smaller sign, less than sign, because these numbers are less than 55 and 55 is less than 63. Okay, then see, 63 is written already. Then only one number is remaining and we write here last, at the last, 80. Because 80 is the greatest number in these four numbers. Okay, see, first we write smaller number, then forget this number, remaining in the remaining number, then write smaller number. In that remaining three numbers, we write in small number. Then 55 is written, then after only two numbers are remaining here, and these two numbers, 63 is small, so we write here 63, and at the last we write the greatest number. So ascending order like this, okay? You write like this also, 40, 55 using the comma, 63, 80. You write like this also, okay? You write, one way is writing for this, is this, and second way is this. If you write this, is this correct? And you write this, then this also is correct answer, okay? Then this, next, descending order. Descending order. See here, descending order is opposite to the ascending order. See, in ascending order we first write the small number. But in descending order, you write the bigger number first, greatest number. Okay? Then which is the greatest number? This one, 80. Okay? Is greater than. Because 80 is the greatest number in these four numbers. Then write 63. Then 40 and 50 is remaining. 40 and 50 out of these two numbers, 55 is the greatest number. So we write 55. And at the last we write the small number. 40. Okay, first we write biggest number, then bigger number, and then 55, and last smaller number. Okay, also we have to write like this, 80, 63, 55, and 40 using the comma. Okay, understood this, how to write the ascending order and descending order. Okay, you remember only in ascending order write smaller number first, and descending order we write the bigger number, okay, or greatest number first. Then see, take next example also. Second example, see here. See here, 3 digits numbers are here, okay? Then see, first ascending order. See, in ascending order, you write the first number is small number, okay? Then see, in these three numbers, which number is small number? See, 217, 211 and 215. See, your first digit are same. Okay? Then see, your second digit also same. Okay? Then check third digit. In 217, 7 is the third digit. In 211, 1 and 215, 5. So, which is the small digit? 7, 1 or 5? 1. 1 is the small. That's why 211 is the small number. Okay? Then write 211. Then forget this number. Remaining these two numbers, 217 and 215. Out of these two numbers, which number is small? 215. Right? 215. And at the last, 270. Okay? Then descending. Descending order. See, in the descending order, we write last number in ascending order first. Bigger number or greatest number. 270. After that, 250. And last one, smaller number. 211. It's very easy. Only you remember that in ascending order, write first smaller number and in descending greatest number first. Okay? Remember this thing, then easy to write this ascending order and descending order. See here, on page number 14, there are some examples for solving you You write these examples in your notebook and complete. Okay, solve this. Then the next point is place value. Place value of the numbers. Place value. Place value. See here. Here a number is given to write the place value. Okay. यहाँ पे एक नंबर दिया जाता है जिसके नीचे अंडरलाइन किया होता है जिस डिजिट की प्लेस वैल्यू हमें लिखनी है. ओके. वी हैव टू राइट द प्लेस वैल्यू ऑफ दैट डिजिट. ओके. सी हियर प्लेस वैल्यू मींस द डिजिट इंडिकेट्स व्हिच प्लेस. ओके. द डिजिट इंडिकेट्स व्हिच प्लेस दैट वैल्यू इज रिटर्न एज आंसर ऑफ दिस. ओके. देन सी हियर टेक वन एग्जांपल हियर.
Below, okay, in that
example we write the underline with its place value. Okay, see here in this example the underline sign is below this 9. Okay, so we have to write only this number digits place value. Okay, in this number here 9 is at 100 place. Okay, so 9's place value is 900. Okay, then see another example, 480. In this number the underline is below the 8. Okay, so we have to write here only place value of this 8. The 8 is at the tens place. Okay, so 8 tens means 80. 8 tens means 80. Like this you solve all these examples. Here one question is given for you, write the place values of the underlined digits. Okay, जो डिजिट्स अंडरलाइन है उसकी प्लेस वैल्यू आपको लिखनी है. ये कंप्लीट करना है आपको. ओके, देन सी नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, एक्सपांडेड फॉर्म. दिस इज द लास्ट पॉइंट ऑफ दिस लेसन. सी एक्सपांडेड फॉर्म, एक्सपांडेड फॉर्म. Here one number is given here. Here take one example here, 998. Then we write here expanded form of this number. What is mean by expanded form? See here, you know you learn about the place value. Okay, अभी हमने जो place value learn किए वही place value सिर्फ addition form में लिखना होता है. Okay, we write the place values of these all three digits in the form of the addition. Okay, let's see here. You need tens and hundred. Okay, let's see here. What is the place value of this 9? 9 is at 100 place, so place value of 9 is 900. Okay, then do plus addition sign here. Okay, then after this 9, this place you write here the place value of this 9. 9 is at 10th place, so place value of this 9 is 90. Okay, then write here addition sign, and last write the place value of last digit 8, the place value of this unit place. Okay, see here, first we write the place value of first digit at the 100 place. Okay, then second digit at the 10th place, and last unit place. So this is called the expanded form of this number. Okay, understood? Okay, take one example. Therefore, these are the expanded form of this number. Okay? Then see, if expanded form of given for you, okay, and we have to write the number opposite, okay, if expanded form of given for you, then how to write the number, then see here, first we check the expanded form, see here 900, then 90 and then 8. See here, first we write the 100 place, okay, 100 place, write the 9 digit, because 9 is here. Then after 100, which place comes? 10th place. Then we have to write this 9 at the 10th place, okay, and after that 10th place, you need place. So we have to write here 8, like this, okay. If you given for the expanded form and you write the numbers, then it is also easy. You take these digits and write here, okay. See here, at the last example, in the last example, see here, how to write the number. We write the first 100 place. Then see here, 3 is at 100 place. And after 100 place, 10th place. Which number is at 10th place? 0. So we write here 0. And at the last, 1. Okay, 301 is the number of this expanded form. Okay. At the last, see what is mean by 1000. See here, introduction of number 1000. See here, last point, introduction of 1000. See here, in short, we learn this 1000. Okay, see here, tell me. What is the greatest three digit number? Which is the greatest three digit number? See here, smallest three digit number is 100. Okay, and greatest three digit number is 999. Is the greatest three digit number. If we add 1 to this number, okay, if we add 1 to this number, 999. Which number we get? See here, 9 plus 1, 10, write 0 here, 1 here in the form of carrier, okay. 9 and 1 is 10, write 0 here, 1 here, okay. 9 and 1 is 10. So we get the 4 digit number here, okay. We get this 4 digit number, and this number is called 1000, okay. This number is called 1000. And 1000 means 10 hundreds. This also called 10 hundreds. Okay. See, in your textbook page number 18. See here. Here one string is of 10 bits. So 10 this. In the one line, 10 bit, 10 strings are here. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 strings. And up to this 100 tens here, okay, these all 100 tens, so 100 tens means 1000, only remember that this number is called 1000, okay, and these are the 4 digit number. Then see, in this lesson we learn about 3 digit numbers, place values, expanded form, after and before numbers, using the symbols greater and smaller. You all, these terms you learn at home, okay, and practice for all that terms, examples, to solve the examples. If we does not solve the example, you forget these terms, okay. So we learn this all terms at home and also complete your workbook. See, this is our math workbook. You complete the lesson second, we have completed, okay, then we complete complete this workbook. First lesson also completed. So we complete the lesson first.